Hello, I'm Mike. In today's video, I shall share an approach to use Excel VBA user form for dependent drop-down list to select item when you use Excel as tool to collect inputs from your organization for analysis and reporting. Here is my example Excel template tool with VBA coded functions to collect sales account info and contact info for analysis and development. The workbook has analysis worksheets, for example, could be sales white space analysis or sales strategy development, which is designed for each target customer account. To stamp the account and contact info for those inputs, we have designed front pager, which we request the business analysis to fill in the beginning of the activities of analysis and developments, such as some events like the interview and workshops. In front pager, we request the region names and account names as key input, also account contact and sales representative name, etc. Also, the required storage path for saving the input template file. For example, we have two drop-down lists created in the template, one for region name, second one is dependent list for account name. We applied the VBA user form to improve the input interface for user easily to find account, especially from a long account list, and make an easy selection in the form, rather than the simple Excel drop-down list window, which has the limits of the row number and the column widths. In the template, we also set up the if and else rule in data validation formula. For the situation when account name selected, user cannot change the region name unless he clears the previous account selection. This rule can avoid the error when user switched to the new region selection but leave old account name in a selection field. Further, to support this if and else rule to clear selection, we introduce a simple macro to reset the selection by one click button. From the later demo, you may find how easily we can create an Excel macro by macro recording feature. We have a fault path field created for user to fill for saving the template. By the field, a predefined path can be given if we want. We also have the two additional fields for registering account contact name and sales representative name. You may also apply drop-down list here for them if you have a predefined list. Finally, we have a VBA save file button. By clicking on it, user can save the file to a predefined folder by naming convention to the file name according to his or her inputted account info and contact info. A bonus hint here is by VBA project view, we can see two additional tabs, DIM underscore account and admin, beside the other three visible tabs. These two tabs have been very hidden by VBA project property setup. User cannot find or hide them in Excel window. This is a benefit for metadata admin in the workbook. Now we know how the template looks like and for what purpose. To set up this feature in template, I shall use four videos to share the creation steps. In this video, part one, I shall focus on how to create the dependent drop-down list by index, match, unique, and indirect functions. Part two video, I shall focus on how to create the list box by VBA user form for selecting items from the drop-down list. Part three video, I shall shortly brief on how to deep hidden dimension and admin tabs, and also give a hint on how to protect the front pager with the editable fields. Last video, part 4, I shall share a VBA procedure to save file by naming conventions. Let's get started by looking this Excel template draft, which has the introduced front pager and on high DIM underscore account tab and admin tab. In DIM underscore account tab, we have the three columns, account name, account region, and account ID. For each region, we have a long list of accounts. Move to the entity admin tab, let's create a short list for region from the DIM underscore account tab. In top cell, enter the formula equals to unique open bracket. Move to DIM underscore account tab and highlight the column B from B2 to B358. Close bracket, we have unduplicated three region names in the list. Let's prepare the region name for the three regions regarding the accounts. Just use a simple text compilation formula. We have the three region name ready in the matrix. Click the Name Manager under the Formulas ribbon. Create the ranger for each region by using previous created ranger name. The each ranger should cover at least all accounts in. Have a quick view to ensure the right list covered in each range. Now we are ready to create the drop-down list in front page. For region, the drop-down list is simple to be created by using the region list from the admin tab in data validation formula box. To create the dependent drop-down list for accounts, let's create the draft formula to map the region's ranging name according to selected region by index and match function. In any cell, enter equals to index. For the mapped array, choose the created matrix A1 to B3 from the admin tab. For find the mapped row number, we use the match function. In the match function, we look up the selected region in front page G10. Lookup array is the region list A1 to A3 in admin tab. Use exact match type 0. Close the bracket for row number index mapping. For column number index mapping, we enter 2, which is the column number of matrix A1 to B3 of admin tab. Enter double close bracket. In the draft formula, we see a return value is the text string of region underscore east. If we change the region to central and west in G10, we see that we get the corresponding ranging name for region. Now we can create the drop-down list by copy and paste the draft formula. As the return value from the pasted formula is the text string, we need to apply indirect function to the pasted formula and return a list for the data validation formula. Regarding the indirect function usage case, please refer to my created video before. Now we have the account drop-down list ready. Let's have a quick check and they are fine. But we find an issue here from our practice is that when we completed a round selection for region and account logically, some user may change in the region selection again, but forget to choose account accidentally, and leave the previous selected account in selection. This may cause wrong inputs to our analysis and reporting. To avoid the error due to this kind of behavior, we have added one rule into region drop-down list, i.e., we only allow the user to change in the region selection when account selection is empty. This rule may avoid error but sometimes inconvenience to use, such as how and when to clear the selection manually. For this situation, one suggested improved option is to introduce a one-click macro button to reset the selection. This creation can be easily done by recording a simple macro. To create a macro, we have to enable the developer in top ribbon. If you do not see the developer in your workbook, on left top corner, click File, choose Option. In left sidebar, choose the Customize ribbon. On the right side, in the Customize the ribbon dialog box, choose All tab or Main tab, then check in the Developer tick box. Now we can record a macro by click the recording macro. Give the name to the macro, reset selection, and store it in this book. OK for start recording. In my setup, I choose the ranging covers G10 and G11. Then right click and choose clear contents. Click stop recording. We have a macro created. To view the VBA codes, choose the Visual Basic icon. Under VBA project window, click the module 1 we just created. We see the VBA procedure. Reset selection, which has a 3 executable, 3 lines in between sub and end sub. There are the actions to select the ranging, clear contents, and the mouse back on a cell. To run the macro, we can create the command button by insert button from form control box and place it beside the two drop-down list fields. It will pop up a dialog box. Assign the created macro reset selection, which from our template file. OK. We get executable button ready. Name the button as reset selections. And format the name by our favorite font style and color. Do a test by filling item selections. Click the button. It is working as we expected. Lastly, import step is to save the file as macro enable with .xlsm extension if the workbook is other extension format. Otherwise, we may lose our created macro. By this phase, we have a dependent drop-down list created with a reset selection macro button for the front pager. If we select the region and then select the account, you will see we have a limited size of view window which has a limited row numbers to select the account from long list of accounts. To have a user-friendly interface to selected item, in next video, part 2, I shall share you a video on how to create the list box by VBA user form feature. Thanks for your watching. If you like to watch more videos from the channel, please press the subscriber button in below. See you in next video.